Acne is a multifactorial disease, meaning that it's not just one thing that contributes to the development of acne. We know now that it is a disease of our oil glands, and so those getting clogged really contribute to the development of whiteheads, blackheads, pustules, which are little kind of white inflamed areas of the skin, and also deep lesions of acne. There is a bacteria that's associated with acne called Propionibacterium acnes, or P. acnes. It doesn't cause infection in the skin, it actually just induces inflammation of our hair follicles and contributes to the development of acne lesions. There's also hormones that play a role in acne, and specifically our androgens, which are the male hormones that get secreted from our adrenal glands. And that's why we see an influx of acne as kids hit puberty. Our hormones are kind of revving up and acne starts to rear its ugly head. Women also get acne. We call it hormonal acne as they get older, related to the hormonal changes we get with our menstrual cycles. One of the ways that I like to kind of start treating acne when it first develops or when it's very mild is with some over-the-counter acne washes that you can get at almost any drugstore. The one that I like the best is called benzoyl peroxide. This comes in the form of a gel as a spot treatment or a wash that you can utilize in the shower. The only downside to benzoyl peroxide is it can be a little irritating to the skin, and it can also bleach your towels. And so you just wanna make sure you're using white towels. There are other types of treatments that I like to use for acne when the acne starts to get revved up. And the best player in terms of acne treatment are our retinoids. These help with increasing cell turnover, so they spit out the clogged pores and kind of bring deep acne lesions to the surface and out of the body. So they're great at preventing acne when acne starts to develop. They're not a good spot treatment, but they're really great as an arsenal in terms of fighting off acne that's there. There's another treatment that I like to talk to patients about. It's buying a hydrocolloid patch. And what they do is you put them on at night on top of a whitehead or a little acne bump, and it helps to draw out the whitehead safely into the patch so that when you take it off in the morning, the acne lesion is gone. I often tell patients we all pick or pop at something on our skin. Some patients bite their nails, some pop their pimples, but we all do it. And it's very tempting when an acne pimple shows up to pop it. However, I strongly encourage my patients to forego that, because what it does is it can introduce more inflammation into that acne lesion that can then cause dark spots that are left behind and even permanent scarring. For my patients who have acne on the chest and the back, I often recommend that after you exercise, if you're wearing a sports bra or if you're getting quite sweaty, make sure you're washing the skin off. Get the sweat particles off of the skin, because that helps to really occlude those hair follicles. There's also benzoyl peroxide wash, which I mentioned, that can be employed on the chest and the back, and it really helps to decrease that P. acnes bacteria that contributes to the development of acne lesions at those locations. So a lot of patients try home remedies before they come in to see me in the office, and a lot of the things that they try make me quite nervous. Some things that are employed a lot are alcohol-based toners or pads, or even using isopropyl alcohol to help treat acne lesions. Although it can be very helpful for infections and wounds, I don't recommend these products for treatment of acne because it's very harsh on the skin. Other things that patients do are using scrubs that are quite abrasive to the skin. And what you're doing is you're actually reintroducing inflammation into the hair follicles. And that can leave behind dark spots and also the risk for scarring. Dermatologists are available and want to see any patient with any acne concern. So at the earliest stages of acne, up until acne that's very severe, we have great treatments we can use that are gentle, mild for, you know, younger children. And then we have more aggressive treatments for acne that we can prescribe through prescription medications or prescription topicals. There's also a special patient population when it comes to acne and acne treatments that are available over the counter, and those would be patients who are pregnant. A lot of treatment that is available over the counter, although safe and FDA approved for acne, are actually not safe or indicated in pregnancy. And so I encourage patients, if you're pregnant and dealing with acne that's coming up, please talk to your OBGYN or make an appointment to see a dermatologist to see what is safe for you to use. Acne is almost a fact of life. I see it in many patients, from young children to even my elderly patients. The best thing you can do is use some of these tips and tricks that I provided today in this video. And if you're struggling with acne beyond what you can do over the counter or at home, I really encourage you to make an appointment with your dermatologist to see what else is available for you.